You underestimate my power!
Nice.
Water tribe.
You've all seen this effect. It's very popular, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to recreate this effect for free in DaVinci Resolve. I'm also going to be giving away a new free preset for Resolve that lets you create this effect in seconds. Let me demonstrate. Here I have this clip.
You underestimate my power!
And in my effects library, under effects, I have this meme stretch effect. This is the free preset I'm giving away. So I'm just gonna drag this right onto that clip in the timeline. And then now if I play,
you underestimate my power.
And we even have some cool custom controls for this. I'll select the clip, go to my inspector, click over to effects, and you'll see that first I have this scale. That is how far you want to stretch over the duration of this clip. If I were to change this to 2, the effect wouldn't be as extreme. If I were to crank this up to 5, it would be very extreme. But I found 3 to be a decent stretch factor. And then you also have a simple saturation control if you really want to beef it up or go down to black and white. And then I also have a master transparency slider that will lower the transparency on the entire image if you want to display any sort of stretched meme over your gameplay footage or any other type of video. This is very cool and very useful. And like all of my other free presets for Resolve, all you need to do to get access to this amazing new free preset is to like this video and subscribe. Or check the download link in the description. But we're gonna move on and demonstrate a few different ways to achieve this effect manually. I know I just give you a free preset to do this all for you, but it's still important to know the process. Especially if you wanna create a similar effect or if you wanna take this effect and modify it in any number of creative ways. The first method is very simple. I have a clean copy of the clip here. And with that clip selected in the inspector, I'm going to come down to where it says transform. And the first thing I'm going to do is click this little chain icon to gray that out. And what that does is separate the X and the Y dimensions of this zoom parameter. If I were to leave that on and increase this number, you would see it would be a normal zoom or scale. But if I uncheck this, when I increase the X zoom, you'll see that this is really the effect we're going for. So I'm going to set this to 1, make sure I'm at the beginning of the clip, and click this diamond over here to set a keyframe. Then I'm going to go to the end of my clip, set another keyframe, and increase this zoom to whatever extent you want. And then if you play back that clip, it will zoom appropriately. But next I want to demonstrate the specific method I used when I built my preset. And for some very specific reasons. Manual keyframing, like our first example, can be quick, but it's not very flexible if you want to go back and change the speed or your clip length after the fact. So for the second example, I have another clean copy of this clip, and with our playhead over that clip, we are going to click this button to open the Fusion page. And in the Fusion page, you will see this bare bones node tree. We have the media in, which is our source clip, and then the media out, which will take whatever we do on the Fusion page and send it back to the edit page. So we're gonna make sure this media in is selected, and we're going to come up and press this icon that says transform. We'll click that, and it will add a transform node between those media in and media out nodes. And with that transform selected over here in the inspector, you'll see a transform section that looks very similar to what we had on the edit page. But instead of those zoom parameters, we have size and aspect. Size will be similar to those length parameters, and aspect is just scaling it up on this Y axis. But if we uncheck use size and aspect, you'll see again, we have X size and Y size, but we're not going to keyframe them. Instead, I'm going to right click on X size and go to modify with anim curves. Anim Curves is a modifier, a special kind of tool in Fusion. And this is a brand new tool. This was just added in Resolve 17. This modifier is very useful if you are creating custom transition presets, but also useful for situations like these. With our transform still selected in the inspector, we're going to change from this tools over to modifiers here. And here you'll see a couple controls. And like I said, we're not creating a transition here. So I'm actually going to change this source parameter from transition to duration. Now let me explain how this modifier works. You can apply it to almost any parameter in the Fusion page. And then over the course of the clip, since we have it set to duration, it will change that parameter based on the scale. This is the same scale parameter that we have in the free preset. You'll remember ours was set to 3, but this is set to 5. So by the end of the clip, it is that much more exaggerated stretch. So if I pull down this to 3, it'll look better. But then if we go to the beginning of the clip, you'll see that instead of filling the frame like normal, it scales down and almost disappears. And that's because of the way anim curves work. It goes from zero to whatever the scale is. But we can address this by going to this offset underneath scale and just changing that to one, telling the modifier to start at a value of one and go to a value of three over the duration of a clip. So now if we just scrub this in the Fusion page, you'll see that move is exactly what we want. And if we go to the edit page, it will be reflected there as well. And I know that seemed like quite a bit more work than just applying manual keyframes, but I also want to demonstrate the flexibility of this approach. Remember that this is looking at the duration of the clip. So if for whatever reason you decided that you only wanted to use the second half of this clip, then you could drag in the beginning of this clip to wherever you wanted to start, and that scale will be reflected. It'll still look normal at the beginning, and over a shorter period of time, so it'll scale faster, but you'll get to that same 3x scale on the X value. But now I do need to address a small issue you might run into. If I drag this back to that original duration and attempt to play back, you'll see it scales up, but then all of a sudden it jumps back and it's not really sure what's going on. And if you jump to the Fusion page, you won't see that same jump reflected. And that has to do with caching. When we had the shorter clip, you'll see that because here in playback Fusion memory cache, because we have this turned on, it had at first a red bar that slowly turned to a blue bar. That is Resolve caching the Fusion clip in memory so that it plays back smoother. It's essential for more complicated scenes. But what happened here is that it cached while we had the effect on a shorter period of time, and then when we increased it, it didn't quite know how to handle that, so it snapped, and we're sort of repeating this motion twice. But here's how to solve that. I will select the clip, go up to Playback, Delete Render Cache, and choose Selected Clips. Then click Delete, and then now if you scrub over that clip, you'll see it starts normal and stretches out over the entire duration like we know it should. This method gives you a lot of flexibility, and it's the reason I use the method in the free preset I created. So if you drop that preset on any clip, no matter the length, it will execute that move over the length of that clip. As always, I really hope this video was useful to you. If it was and you want to learn more about DaVinci Resolve or check out some more free presets for Resolve, hop on over to my channel. And if you want to be sure you don't miss any exciting videos or presets in the future, consider subscribing. Thanks, I'll see you next time.